Now we come to Surah Al-Qasas. This surah contains quite detailed narrative about the life story of Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wassalam. We have read it in detail in Surah Al-Taha. Five sections of that surah, they were, you know, occupied by the story of Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wassalam. Here again, Surah Al-Qasas, it is giving some additional details. Some of the things are repeated, and there are other things which are additional. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Qasimim. Tilka ayatul kitabil mubin. These are the ayat of the clear book, manifest book. Natlu alaykum min naba'i Musa wa Fir'aun. We are going to recite to you the story of Musa and Fir'aun, bilhaq, with truth. Everything that we say is 100% correct. لِقَوْمِ يُؤْمِنُونَ, for those people who believe. إِنَّ فِرْعَوْنَ عَلَى فِي الْأَرْضِ. Verily, Fir'aun had exalted himself in the land. وَجَعَلَ أَهْلَهَا شِيعًا. And he had made the people, divided them into sects and groups. يَسْتَضْعِفُ طَائِفَةً مِّنْهُمْ. He was slaughtering their sons, yastadhafu, abasing and oppressing some of them. Yuzabbihu abnaahum, slaughtering their sons, yastahyi nisaahum, and keeping alive their women. Innahu kana min al-mufsideen. No doubt, surely, he was of the corruptors and the mischief mongers. You know, this was the command of Fir'aun at that time, that every male child born to any Israeli woman must be killed. Now, what was the reason? There's no mention in Quran. There's no mention in Torah even. But there are some stories in Talmud. And you know, our Mufassirin have also borrowed them from Talmud. That is, that the Fir'aun, he saw a dream that a child is born to an Israeli woman who will overthrow his kingdom. So, on the basis of this vision and dream, he gave the order. Whosoever Israeli woman bears a male child, kill. But the second reason can be, as I told you, it was a nationalist strife. Because Bani Israel were very prosperous. When they had entered Egypt, the kings at that time, the king was not a pharaoh. He was not a son of the soil. He was not an Egyptian. They were from the Amalekah. And actually they were Arabs. So they were, so to say, foreign occupiers of Egypt. And they needed some section of the population to support them against any local nationalistic uprising. So he gave the best land to Bani Israel, Joshua, you know, near the delta of Nile, the best lands he gave to the Israelites. You go settle here. And they were very prosperous. And they multiplied in great number. But after some years, then there was a revolt, local revolt, an uprising. The local peoples drove out the Amalekah. They had to run away. And now this was a nationalist resurgence in Egypt. Again, now the dynasty of Pharaoh started. And now these people, who were pampered during the former king and in their regimes, now they were persecuted. They were thought to be the agents of those enemies of Egypt. But because they were increasing in number, they were fearing that they might sometime challenge us in our land. And we have read, you know, that Fir'aun said, these are two magicians who want to drive you out of your land. So he was saying it, that actually it's a political, you know, scheme. And they want to deprive us of this land of ours, Egypt, and to occupy it. And there are a great number of Israelis are there, and now he has come equipped with these, you know, magic things. So that is the fear. So maybe any one of these two things can be true. Inna Fir'auna ala fil ard, verily Fir'aun exalted himself in the earth, in the land. Waja'ala ala shi'an, and made its people, divided them into sects and groups. Yastad'ifu ta'ifata minhum. One of the groups he was oppressing. Yuzabbihu abna'ahu, to the extent that he was killing their sons, male sons, yastahyi nisa'ahum, and keeping alive their female daughters, their female progeny. But Nuridu, innahu kana min al-mufsidin, definitely he was from among the corruptors and the mischief mongers. But Nuridu an namunna ala al-lazina stud'afu. And we had decided that we shall bestow our favor on those who were oppressed in the land. So now we wanted to come to help of Bani Israel, to relieve them, to get the release for them. Nuridu an namunna ala al-lazina stud'afu فِي الْأَرْضِ وَنَجْعَلَهُمْ أَيْمَّةً, and we make them the leaders, وَنَجْعَلَهُمُ الْوَارِثِينَ, and make them the inheritors of the rule in this land. وَنُمَكِّنَ لَهُمْ فِي الْأَرْضِ, and that we should establish them in the land. وَنُرِيَ فِرْعَوْنَ وَهَامَانَ وَجُنُودَهُمَا, and show to Fir'aun and Haman and their hosts and their armies, minhum ma kanu yahzarun, what they were dreading or fearing. I have given you the detail of this dreading and fearing of what? Either the domination of Bani Israel in Egypt due to their numbers, and now Moses by their side, Musa alayhi salatu wasalam also with them. Or as the stories are and the traditions are, that he had seen a dream that a child is born to Bani Israel who overthrows his kingdom. But we decided to show him that this is going to happen. You might have killed thousands of the sons of Bani Israel, but still, you know, one was saved. Who had to overthrow your kingdom, he was saved. Because Allah Ta'ala does what he wants. Now this we have read in Surah Taha. And we sent the revelation to the mother of Musa, alayhi salatu wasalam, an arzi'ihe, go on suckling him. Faida khifti alayhi, then when you have a fear that he might be found out, when the people, you know, searching the homes are coming, falqihe fil yam, then you cast him into the Nile, into the river. Wala takhafi, don't fear. وَلَا تَحْزَنِي, and don't grieve. إِنَّا رَادُّهُ إِلَيْكِ, we promise we shall return him to you. وَجَعَلُوهُ مِنَ الْمُرْسَلِينَ, and we will make him from among our messengers. Now this is the wahi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala coming to a woman. But she was not prophet. Allah can send wahi and ilham to other people also. Even we have read, Aha Rabbuka ila Nahl, Allah sent the wahi to the honeybee. Whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts in some animals as instincts, it's also a wahi to them from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But this, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent this message to the mother of Musa. فَالْتَقَطَهُ عَالُ فِرْعَونَ, so the people of Fir'aun picked him up from the river. لَيَكُونَ لَهُمْ عَدُوًّا وَحَزَنًا, so that he might become for them enemy and the reason of grief. إِنَّ فِرْعَوْنَ وَهَامَانَ وَجُنُودَهُمَا, verily, not only Fir'aun and Haman, but all of their armies, كَانُوا خَاتِئِينَ, they committed a mistake. They were evildoers, and now they committed this mistake because they did not kill Musa. Why didn't they kill? وَقَالَتْ إِمْرَأَةُ فِرْعَوْنَ, now the wife of Fir'aun came in the way. They wanted, they had recognized that this is an Israeli child. But now, wife who was beloved of Fir'aun, she came in between, قَالَتْ إِمْرَأَةُ فِرْعَوْنَ قُرَّةٌ لِي وَلَكَ قُرَّةُ عَيْنٍ لِي وَلَكَ. Oh, Fir'aun, this child will be a coolness to my eyes and yours. And we have read already, أَلْقَيْتُ عَلَيْكَ مَحَبَّةً مِنِّي. Allah has put on Musa alayhi salam, you know, a reflection of his own love. Whosoever saw him started loving him. So both these things. Firstly, the appearance of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, a very beautiful, very lovely child. Secondly, this wife. Torah says she was daughter of Fir'aun, but Quran says no, she was the wife of Fir'aun. And she has been mentioned in Surah Al-Tahrim as one of the most exemplary women. Because although she was living in the house of Fir'aun, an enemy of Allah, but she was herself a saint. A waliullah, waliyah lillah. And she was from among the Israelites. She was an Israeli woman. Just as you know, kings, they marry. Some woman might have been very beautiful, and he liked her and brought her in the palace. قَالَتْ إِمْرَأَةُ فِرْعَوْنَ قُرَّةُ عَيْنٍ لِي وَلَكَ لَا تَقْتُلُوهُ. Don't kill him. عَسَىٰ يَنْفَعَنَا. Maybe he proves to be beneficial for us. أَوْ نَتَّخِذَهُ وَلَدًا. Or we shall adopt him as a son. Because they had no son till that time. After some time, there was a son. And that was the Fir'aun when Hazrat Musa comes back from Madian. Now he was the Fir'aun. But till this time, the father was in charge. أَوْ نَتَّخِذَهُ وَلَدًا وَهُمْ لَا يَشْعُرُونَ. And they didn't know what they are doing. They were actually their enemy, Musa, who will overthrow their kingdom. But they have decided not to kill him. وَأَصْبَحَ فُعَادُ أُمِّ مُوسَى فَارِغًا. And in the meantime, the heart of Musa's mother became empty. You know, her courage gave way. The love and affection for the son, she couldn't bear anymore. In قَادَتْ لُتُمْنِي بِهِ. She was very close to disclose everything. She was close that she would have exploded that this was my son and I have done this and I have, you know, cast him into the Nile. And so go and see and please, please take it back. لَوْلَا أَنْ رَبَطْنَا عَلَىٰ قَلْبِهَا. Had we not strengthened her heart, we strengthened her heart so that she could bear. لَتَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. So that she becomes from among the believers. وَقَالَتْ لِأُخْتِهِ. And she said to his sister, sister of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, قُسِّيهِ. Go and follow. You know, that basket or whatever you may call, which was carrying Musa alayhi salam, the Nile, go along with the coast of the river, see. Pussihe, go along with it. فَبَصُرَتْ بِهِ عَنْ جُنُبٍ. So she kept an eye on that basket or whatever it was, a box, عَنْ جُنُبٍ, from afar, a distance. وَهُمْ لَا يَشْعُرُونَ. They didn't know that, you know, someone is watching this child. وَحَرَّمْنَا عَلَيْهِ الْمَرَاضِعَ مِنْ قَبْلِ. And we had prevented him beforehand to drink the milk of all the foster mothers. So many women were called, said that she should suckle him. But he didn't accept. He won't touch the mammary gland of the mother, of that foster mother. So all were tried, but Moses alayhi salatu wasalam accepted none. So now there was an emergency. How will he live? He is not ready to accept the milk of any woman. So then she said, the sister, وَحَرَّمْنَا عَلَيْهِ الْمَرَاضِعَ مِنْ قَبْلِ فَقَالَتْ هَلْ أَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَىٰ أَهْلِ بَيْتٍ يَكْفُلُونَهُ. Should I guide you to a family who will be able to take care of him. وَهُمْ لَهُ نَاصِحُونَ And they are for him, they will look after him and they are sincere to him. فَرَدَدْنَاهُ إِلَىٰ أُمِّهِ In this way, we returned him to his mother. كَيْ تَقَرَّ عَيْنُهَا So that her eyes should remain cool. وَلَا تَحْزَن And she should not be grieved. وَلَتَعْلَمَ And so that she should come to know and believe. أَنَّ وَعَدَ اللَّهِ حَقٌّ That the promise of Allah is true. What he had said, إِنَّا رَادُّوهُ إِلَيْكِ We shall return your son to you. Don't worry. لَا تَحْزَنِي Don't worry. عَلَىٰ أَنَّ وَعَدَ اللَّهِ حَقٌّ وَلَكِنَّ أَكْسَرَهُمْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ But most of them know not. They don't have the true knowledge. But some of the very important events of the early childhood and infancy period of Hazrat Musa alayhi salatu wasalam have been repeated in Quran thrice. We read them in Surah Al-Shu'ara, in Surah Al-Taha, and lastly we read them in the first section of Surah Al-Qasas. But now this period, which is beginning now, it is mentioned only in Surah Al-Qasas. وَلَمَّا بَلَغَ أَشُدَّهُ When he reached his maturity, وَاسْتَوَى And became firm, آتَيْنَاهُ حُكْمًا وَعِلْمًا We granted him the true judgment and knowledge. وَكَذَلِكَ نَجْزِ الْمُحْسِنِينَ And in this way we reward those who do good deeds. وَدَخَلَ الْمَدِينَةَ عَلَىٰ هِينِ غَفْلَةٍ مِّنْ أَهْلِهَا And he entered the city at a time when the people, the inhabitants, were not vigilant. Time might have been early morning or during the noon, when the people, you know, they are resting in their homes. فَوَجَدَ فِيهَا رَجُلَيْنِ يَقْتَتِلَانِ Now he entered the city. Why? Because, you know, he was living in the palace. And palaces are outside the cities. So from his palace, he came to the city. And went in there. فَوَجَدَ فِيهَا رَجُلَيْنِ يَقْتَتِلَانِ He found two persons fighting with each other. هَذَا مِنْ شِيَعْتِهِ This was from his people, that is, Bani Israel. وَهَذَا مِنْ عَدُوِهِ And the other one, from his enemy. The Coptics, the Egyptian. فَاسْتَغَاسَهُ الَّذِي مِنْ شِيَتِهِ So the person who was from his own people, Bani Israel, he asked for help. عَلَى الَّذِي مِنْ عَدُوِّهِ Against whom? Against that one who was from his enemy. فَوَكَذَهُ مُوسَى So Musa struck him with his fist. فَقَضَى عَلَيْهِ And finished him. قَالَ هَذَا مِنْ عَمَلِ الشَّيْطَانِ Actually, he didn't intend to kill him. But you know, one strike with fist, you know, that was sufficient for him to finish him. So he said, هَذَا مِنْ عَمَلِ الشَّيْطَانِ This is from Satan's doing. إِنَّهُ عَدُوٌّ مُضِلٌّ مُبِينٌ Surely he is an enemy, misleader, manifestly. قَالَ رَبِّ إِنِّي ظَلَمْتُ نَفْسِي And then he prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Oh my Lord, I have wronged myself. فَغْفِرْ لِي So please forgive me. فَغَفَرَ اللَّهُ So Allah forgave him. إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ Surely he is the forgiver and the merciful. قَالَ رَبِّ بِمَا أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيَّ Now he promised. He made a covenant with Allah. As you have blessed me, فَلَنْ أَكُونَ ظَهِيرًا لِلْمُجْرِمِينَ In future, I will never support any guilty person. فَأَصْبَحَ فِي الْمَدِينَةِ خَائِفًا And in the morning next day, he was in the city fearful and vigilant. He was fearful maybe that the news that an Egyptian was killed by Moses might have reached the authorities and they might be thinking about arresting him and doing something against him. So he was fearful. فَأَصْبَحَ فِي الْمَدِينَةِ خَائِفًا يَتَرَقَّبْ And vigilant, seeing if something is coming from this side or that side. فَإِذَا الَّذِي فَإِذَا الَّذِي اسْتَنْصَرَهُ بِالْأَمْسِ يَسْتَصْرِخُهُ. Suddenly he found that the same person who wanted his help the previous day, he is again crying for his help. قَالَ لَهُ مُوسَىٰ إِنَّكَ لَغَوِيٌّ مُبِينٌ. On that Musa said, you are surely one misled. You were fighting yesterday with one person. I helped you and he was killed. Now you have taken a quarrel with another person, so you seem to be a wrong person. فَلَمَّا أَنْ أَرَادَ. But because he was from Bani Israel, and the other person with whom he was fighting even today, he was from the other party. فَلَمَّا أَنْ أَرَادَ يَبْتِشَ بِالَّذِي هُوَ عَدُوٌّ لَهُمَا. When he intended to seize the person who was the enemy to both, he said, that person to whom he had helped, he said, يَا مُوسَىٰ تُرِيدُ أَن تَقْتُلَنِي. He thought that because he had reproached him, now he is going to reprimand him, and he will take him to the task, and maybe he strikes him. So in that fear he said, يَا مُوسَىٰ تُرِيدُ أَن تَقْتُلَنِي كَمَا قَتَلْتَ نَفْسًا بِالْأَمْسِ. Oh Musa, do you want to kill me? Just as you killed a person previous day? إِن تُرِيدُ إِلَّا أَن تَكُونَ جَبَّارًا. Surely, what you intend is to become a very tyrant, big tyrant in the land, فِي الْأَرْضِ. وَمَا تُرِيدُ أَن تَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُسْلِحِينَ. And you don't intend to be from among the reconcilers. وَجَاءَ رَجَلٌ مِنْ أَقْصَى الْمَدِينَةِ يَسْعَى. And at the same time, a person came running from the farthest end of the city. قَالَ يَا مُوسَىٰ. He said, O Musa, إِنَّ الْمَلَأَ يَعْتَمِرُونَ بِكَ. The chiefs are counseling together in your case. لِيَقْتُلُوكَ. And the resolution is that now you should be killed. فَخْرُجْ إِنِّي لَكَ مِنَ النَّاسِحِينَ. So you run away from here. I am a very sincere advisor for you. If you want to save your life, now you run away from here. فَخَرَجَ مِنْهَا خَائِفًا. So Musa left Egypt, fearful. يَتَرَقَّبُ. And he was vigilant, looking to right and left and behind. Maybe he's being followed, somebody is coming after him. So in this way, he just left Egypt. قَالَ رَبِّ نَجَّنِي مِنَ الْقَوْمِ الظَّالِمِينَ. And he prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my Lord, deliver me from the evil-doing people. وَلَمَّا تَوَجَّهَ تِلْقَاءَ مَدْيَنَ. When he turned his face towards Madian. Now what is Madian? Geographically you should understand. You know the Sinai Peninsula. The Red Sea, when it ends in the north, it divides into two parts. Gulf of Suez, Gulf of Aqaba. And in between these two is the Sinai Peninsula. Now to the west of the Sinai Peninsula is Egypt. To the east here, there was the place where Madian was. And the people, you know, lived there. The people of Madian. Now he had to cross whole of the Sinai Peninsula to go to Madian. The most difficult task. It's a awful desert. But he had to cross it. So when he turned his face towards Madian, he couldn't think of any other place to go and stay there and be secure that he will not be caught there. So he turned his face, started going towards Madian, and he said, Asa Rabbi an yahdiyani sawa sabil. Maybe, and I hope, that my Lord will guide me on the right way. Right way? To Madian. I am not lost in the desert. Walamma warada ma Madiana. Now we don't know how much time he took for crossing on foot the whole Sinai Peninsula, the desert of Sinai. But when he arrived at the water wells of Madian, وَجَدَ عَلَيْهِ أُمَّةً. There he found a group of people, مِنَ النَّاسِ يَسْقُونَ. They were watering their flocks, sheep and goats, flocks coming, and from the well they are drinking and going. Then the next shepherd comes, and he waters his flock. وَوَجَدَ مِنْ دُونِهِمْ إِمْرَأَتَيْنِ تَزُودَانِ. And he find besides them two women keeping back their flocks. They were stopping their, you know, goats and sheep. They shouldn't advance. قَالَ مَا خَطْبُكُمَا. He asked them, what's the matter with you? Why are you not going forward and taking your flocks to drink water? Qalata, both of them said, La nasqi, we don't water our flocks. Hatta yusdana ria, till that time that all these shepherds are gone. Wabuna shaykhun kabir, and our father is a very old person, old man. He's so old, he can't, you know, enter into any fight with anybody here. So if we scuffle with these people, this is my turn, how are you coming? So we can't take that risk. So when all of them have taken their flocks and watered them, then we take the chance. Fasaqa lahuma. But then he advanced. And you know, stopping the others, he watered for their flocks. Summa tawalla ila dhil. And then he returned to something, somewhere in there was a shadow, a shelter. فَقَالَ رَبِّ إِنِّي لِمَا أَنزَلْتَ إِلَيَّ مِنْ خَيْرٍ فَقِيرٍ. Now this is a very important dua. A man in his extreme distress, he knows nobody. He is a stranger here. He has nothing with him. Penniless, tired like anything. Maybe his clothing were also, you know, shattered. He's crossing the whole desert on foot. Now he said, oh my Lord, whatever good you throw in my lap, I am in need of it. You know, there are certain beggars who say, well, I'll take 5 rupees, no less. But there is a beggar who says, okay, even a single penny, I'll accept. So this was the condition of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. Rabbi inni lima anzalta ilayya min, whatever good you can send to me, I am in its need. إِلَيَّ مِنْ خَيْرٍ فَقِيرٍ فَجَاءَتُ إِحْدَاهُمَا تَمْشِي عَلَى اسْتِحْيَاءٍ. So one of those two girls, they came to him walking shyfully. قَالَتْ, and she said, إِنَّ أَبِي يَدْرُوكَ, my father is calling you. لِيَجْزِيَكَ أَجْرَ مَا سَقَيْتَ لَنَا, to give you the wage or reward that you watered our flock. فَلَمَا جَاهُ, when he came to him, وَقَصَّ عَلَيْهِ الْقَصَصِ, and he narrated the whole story, قَالَ لَا تَخَفْ, that old man said, now don't fear. حَدْنَجَوْتَ مِنَ الْقُومِ الظَّالِمِينَ, now you have come away from that zone of danger for you. You have been delivered from those people who are evildoers. Now what the person of this Shaykh of Madian, there are two opinions. One is that he was Hazrat Shuaib alayhi salatu wasalam. And the other is that no. It was much later, much after Hazrat Shuaib's time. And I, you know, subscribe to the second view. He was not Shuaib alayhi salatu wasalam. The conditions which are depicted here, they don't fit in. The life of a messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whether during the period when he is giving the call to the people and conveying the message, or to the period when, you know, the wrongdoers have been exterminated and then a new generation comes up. So both these pictures, they are not fitting here. قَالَتْ إِحْدَاهُمَا يَا أَبَتِ اسْتَعْجِرْهُ. So one of the two girls said, oh my father, hire him. إِنَّ خَيْرَ مِنْ اسْتَعْجَرْتَ أَقَوِيُّ الْأَمِينَ. Definitely, the first person to hire is the one who is strong and trustworthy. Now this was their own experience. How Moses, you know, advanced toward the shepherds and stopped them, and he made way for the flocks of these girls. He was strong, nobody could challenge him. Secondly, he never cast a glance, a lustful glance at the girls. You know, about this thing, you know, women are very sensitive. They can understand. You know, if you are looking upon a woman, she very well knows what is in your heart. She can feel it. So they saw that there is nothing in his eyes, and he is absolutely trustworthy person. He is not a lustful person, not a person given to his worldly and bodily desires. قَالَ إِنِّي أُرِيدُ أَنْ أُنْكِحَكَ إِحْدَى ابْنَتَيَّ هَاتَيْنِ. that old man said, I desire, O Musa, to marry one of these two daughters of mine to you on the condition, Ala anta ajurani samaniya hijaj. But the condition is that you have to serve me for 8 years. فَإِنْ أَكْمَلْتَ عَشَرًا But if you can complete 10, فَأْمِنْ عِنْدِكْ This will be a favor from you. نَافِلَةً لَكْ So this will be a favor from you. وَمَا أُرِدُ أَنَ شُقَّ عَلَيْكْ And I will not be very harsh upon you. سَتَجِدُنِ إِنْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ إِنْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ God willing, you'll find me that I'm a righteous person. قَالَ ذَلِكَ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَكْ Musa said, okay, this is settled and decided between me and you. أَيَّمَ الْأَجَلَيْنِ قَضَيْتُ Any one of these two terms, either 8 years or 10 years, whichever I complete, فَلَا عُدْوَانَ عَلَيَّ Then there should be no injustice to me. وَاللَّهُ عَلَى مَا نَقُولُ وَكِيلٌ And what we are agreeing today, this agreement that we are making, Allah is a witness to that. So if I say, okay, 8 years completed, now let me go with my wife, you will have to do it. But if I like, I will serve for 2 years more. It will be optional. فَلَمَّا قَضَى مُوسَى الْأَجَلِ So when Musa completed the term, وَسَارَ بِأَهْلِهِ And now he departed with his family. آنَسَ مِنْ جَانِبِ تُورِ نَارَ He saw on the side of the Mount Tur, fire. قَالَ لِأَهْلِهِ Now this incident we have read many times. قَالَ لِأَهْلِهِ He said to his family, Unkusu, stay here, wait here. إِنِّي آنَسْتُ نَارَ I have seen fire. لَعَلِّي آتِكُمْ مِنْهَا بِخَبَرٍ Maybe I can bring some news from there and we get the guidance from there. أَوْ جَزْوَةٍ مِنَ النَّارِ Or a brand out of the fire so that you may warm, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَسْتَلُونَ So that you can warm yourself. فَلَمَّا أَتَاهَا When he came to that fire, نُودِيَا It was called مِنْ شَاطِئِ الْوَادِ الْأَيْمَنِ فِي الْبُقْعَةِ الْمُبَارَكَةِ مِنَ الشَّجَرَةِ He was called from the right side of the valley in the blessed ground, from the tree. O Musa, Ya Musa, Inni an Allahu Rabbul Alameen, I am Allah, the Lord of the worlds. Wa an al qiyasak, cast down your staff. فَلَمَّا رَاهَا تَحْتَزُّ كَأَنَّهَا جَانٌ And when he saw it, that it was moving as if it was a snake or a serpent. وَلَّا مُدْبِرًا وَلَمْ يُعَقِّبْ He turned back and retreating and returned not. Then Allah said, Ya Musa, أَقْبِلْ وَلَا تَخَفْ Come back and don't fear. إِنَّكَ مِنَ الْآمِنِينَ You are absolutely insecure and absolutely in peace. اُسْلُكْ يَدَكَ فِي جَيْبِكَ تَخْرُجْ بَيْضَاءَ مِنْ غَيْرِ سُوءٍ Now you enter your hand into your bosom. And now when you take it out, it will be white, without any evil, without any disease. وَضْمُمْ إِلَيْكَ جَنَاهَكَ مِنْ رَحْبٍ And you press your arm with your side if you feel some fear. فَزَانِكَ بُرْحَانَانِ Now these are the two arguments, two miracles that I am giving to you. مِنْ رَبِّكَ From your Lord. إِلَىٰ فِرْعَوْنَ وَمَلَيْهِ Towards Fir'aun and his chiefs. One was that the staff turns into serpent. The other was that when he took his hand into his bosom and then when he brought it out, It was shining white without any disease. But the third thing he gave as a precaution. It was not a sign. It was not a miracle. It was a subjective feeling. Whenever you feel that you are feeling some fear, then you press your arm with your side. So fear will go. So this was going to be a subjective type of thing, not a miracle to be shown to others. So the miracle was two, burhanan. إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا قَوْمًا فَاسِقِينَ Verily, they have become a transgressing people. قَالَ رَبِّ إِنِّي قَتَلْتُ مِنْهُمْ نَفْسًا He said, My Lord, I killed a person of their nation. فَأَخَافُ يَقْتُلُونَ I fear when I go there. They will kill me. وَأَخِي هَارُونَ Now there is my brother, Harun, هُوَ أَفْسَحُ مِنِّي He is more eloquent and fluent than myself. فَأَرْسِلْهُ مَعِيَا. So you send him with me, رِدْعَان, as a helper. يُصَدِّقُنِي. He should confirm me. إِنِّي أَخَافُ أَن يُكَذِّبُونَ. Because I fear that they will belie me. قَالَ سَنَشُدُّ عَضُدَكَ بِأَخِيكَ. Allah said, we shall soon strengthen your arms with your brother. وَنَجْعَلُ لَكُمَا سُلْطَانًا. And we shall give you both the authority. فَلَا يَسِلُونَ إِلَيْكُمَا. They will not be able to come near you, to harm you. بِآيَاتِنَا أَنْتُمَا وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَكُمَا الْغَالِبُونَ. Now this بِآيَاتِنَا you might be seeing. Before this is also a sign of stop. Jim. And after بِآيَاتِنَا again a sign. And three, you know, dots above Jim on both sides. This is called in Quranic terminology Mu'anaka. Mu'anaka means you can read this word بِآيَاتِنَا with the preceding sentence. وَنَجْعَلُ لَكُمَا سُلْطَانٌ فَلَا يَسِلُونَ إِلَيْكُمَا بِآيَاتِنَا. They will not be able to come near you to harm you when you will have these two signs and miracles with you. So due to these miracles, they will not be able to harm you. Or you read it with the next sentence. بِآيَاتِنَا أَنْتُمَا وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَكُمَا الْغَالِبُونَ. Due to our signs, you and those people who will follow you, they will be victors. And they will be triumphants. So this is called Mu'anaka. This word can be attached to the preceding sentence or it can be attached to the following sentence. فَلَمَّا جَاهُمْ مُوسَىٰ بِآيَاتِنَا. When Musa came to them with our clear signs, آيَاتِنَا بَيَّنَاتٍ قَالُوا مَا هَذَا إِلَّا سِحْرُ الْمُفْتَرَىٰ. They said, this is nothing but forged sorcery. وَمَا سَمِعْنَا بِهَذَا فِي آبَائِنَا الْأَوَّلِينَ. We have not listened to such things which you are saying, that there is a creator of the world and he has sent you as a messenger to us. Oh, we have never heard these things. وَمَا سَمِعْنَا بِهَذَا فِي آبَائِنَا الْأَوَّلِينَ. We never listened to these things among our ancient forefathers. وَقَالَ مُوسَى. And Musa said, رَبِّي أَعْلَمُ بِمَنْ جَاءَ بِالْهُدَى مِنْ عِنْدِهِ. My Lord knows best who has brought guidance from him, from his presence. وَمَنْ تَكُونُ لَهُ عَقْبَةُ الدَّارِ. And for whom should be the farther away, عَقْبَةُ الدَّارِ, that abode of Akhirah. إِنَّهُ لَا يُفْلِحُ الظَّالِمُونَ. Verily, the evildoers will not be successful or prosperous. وَقَالَ فِرْعَوْنُ يَا أَيُّهَ الْمَلَأُ. And Fir'aun said, oh my chiefs, مَا عَلِمْتُ لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَٰهِمْ غَيْرِي. I know of no other God for you except me. I am the only God. I am the ruler. I am the sovereign. I am the God. Who is this God about whom Musa is talking? فَأَوْقِدْ لِي يَا هَامَانُ وَلَتِّينَ. So, O Haman, kindle a fire to bake the bricks of clay. أَوْقِدْ لِي يَا هَامَانُ وَلَتِّينَ. فَاجْعَلْ لِي صَرْحًا. Now build for me a lofty tower. لَعَلِّي أَطَّلِعُ إِلَىٰ إِلَٰهِ مُوسَىٰ. So that I can ascend high and then I try to see the Lord and the God of Moses. وَإِنِّي لَأَظُنُّهُ مِنَ الْكَاذِبِينَ. As far as I can understand and think, he is a liar. وَاسْتَكْبَرَ هُوَ وَجُنُودُهُ. So he was arrogant, and not only who, also his armies. فِي الْأَرْضِ, in the earth, in the land. بِغَيْرِ الْحَقِّ. They didn't have any right for that. وَظَنُّوا أَنَّهُمْ إِلَيْنَا لَا يُرْجَعُونَ. And they thought that they will not be returned to us. فَأَخَذْنَاهُ وَجُنُودَهُ. So we seized him, Fir'aun, and his armies. فَنَبَذْنَاهُمْ فِي الْيَمْ. And we threw them into the sea. فَانْظُرْ كَيْفَ كَانَ عَاقِبَةُ الظَّالِمِينَ. Now see, what was the end of the evildoers. وَجَعَلْنَاهُمْ أَئِمَّةً يَدْعُونَ إِلَى النَّارِ. And we had made them the leaders who were calling towards fire. They were calling people towards the fire of hell. وَيَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ لَا يُنْصَرُونَ. Now the day of resurrection and judgment, they will not be able to get any help from any side. وَأَتْبَعْنَاهُمْ فِي هَذِهِ الدُّنْيَا لَعْنَةً. And we made curse to follow them in the life of this world. وَيَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. And that curse will follow them on the day of judgment also. وَهُمْ مِنَ الْمَقْبُوحِينَ. And they will be the ones thrown away from God's mercy. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا مُوسَى الْكِتَابَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا أَهْلَكْنَا الْقُرُونَ الْأُولَى. And after we destroyed the former generation, we gave Musa alayhi salatu wasalam the book, that is Torah. Basaira linnas, it contained enlightenments for mankind, wahudan and a guidance, warahmatan and a mercy, la'allahum yatadhakkarun, so that they may be admonished and reminded. Wama kunta bijanibil gharbiyye. O Muhammad, you were not present, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, on the western side of that Mount Tur. Is qadayna ila Musa al-amr. When we decreed the commandment to Musa, وَمَا كُنْتَ مِنَ الشَّاهِدِينَ. And you were not there as witness. You were not present. That is to say, this is all revelation which is coming to you. You were not there. You didn't know these things before. وَلَكِنَّا نِشَأْنَا قُرُونًا فَتَطَاوَلَ عَلَيْهِمُ الْعُمُرُ. But we created, raised many a generation. And when long were the ages that passed over them, وَمَا كُنْتَ سَاوِيًا فِي أَهْلِ الْمَدْيَنَا. And you were not there, dwelling among the people of Madian, تَتْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِنَا, reciting to them our ayat, our revelations. وَلَكِنَّا كُنَّا مُرْسِلِينَ. But we are the senders. We have sent you, and we have pointed you a messenger, and we are sending you all these revelations. وَمَا كُنْتَ بِجَانِبِ تُورِ إِذْ نَادَيْنَا. Nor were you present on the side of the Mount Tur when we had called. وَلَاكِنْ رَحْمَةً مِّنْ رَبِّكَ. But this is all mercy from your Lord. لَتُنْزِرَ قَوْمًا. So that you warn the nation. And now, who are meant here? Quraysh. لَتُنْزِرَ قَوْمًا. So that you warn the nation. مَا أَتَاهُمْ مِّنْ نَذِيرٍ مِّنْ قَبْلِكَ. To whom no warner has come before you. لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَذَكَّرُونَ. So, hopefully, they might be not admonished or they might be reminded. وَلَوْلَا أَن تُصِيبَهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ بِمَا قَدَّمَتْ أَيْدِيهِمْ. And lest if any affliction should befall them due to what their hands have sent forward. فَيَقُولُوا. And then they say, رَبَّنَا لَوْلَا أَرْسَلْتَ إِلَيْنَا رَسُولًا. O Allah, why didn't you send a messenger first? فَنَتَّبِ آيَاتِكَ. We would have followed your revelations. وَنَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. And we must have been among the believers. فَلَمَّا جَاءَهُمُ الْحَقُّ مِنْ عِنْدِنَا. But now that this truth has come to them from our presence, قَالُوا لَوْلَا أُوتِيَ مِثْلَ مَا أُوتِيَ مُوسَى. Now they are saying, why he has not been given the miracles like the ones which were given to Musa? أَوَلَّمْ يَكْفُرُوا بِمَا أُوتِيَ مُوسَى. Those people, didn't they belie? And then they reject what was given to Musa. All the miracles were shown to those people. Nobody came to believe. Min qabl. Qalu sihran tazahara. Now they are saying these are two sorceries supporting each other. This is a reference to Torah and Quran. Because they both support each other. Quran is also supporting Torah. It was a book from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It contained light. فِيهَا عُدَمْ وَنُورِ. There was light and there was the guidance for Bani Israel. And then in the same way, there are the prophecies in Torah about Quran and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So these are supporting each other. سِحْرَانِ تَذَاهَرَا. These are two sorceries who are supporting each other. وَقَالُوا إِنَّا بِكُلِّ كَافِرُونَ. We reject both of them. We neither believe in Torah nor we believe in Quran. قُلْ فَاتُوا بِكِتَابٍ مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ وَأَهْدَى مِنْهُمَا أَتَّبِعُوا. Say to them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, okay, if you reject Torah, if you reject Quran, now, if you are in kuntum sadiqeen, if you are truthful, bring forth any other scripture from God. It might have been sent by God. قُلْ فَاتُوا بِكِتَابٍ مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ وَأَهْدَى مِنْهُمَا. Who might be more on guidance than these two books? I will follow that. If you have a book Well, bring forth. I will follow that book. I am following Torah also. I am following Quran also. Why shouldn't I follow if there is any other book sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? If you have anyone, present it. فَإِلَّمْ يَسْتَجِيبُوا لَكَ. And now if they don't respond to you, they can't produce another book before you. فَعْلَمْ. Then you should come to know, you should be convinced. أَنَّمَا يَتَّبِعُونَ أَهْوَاهُمْ. That they are following only their lusts and desires and nothing else. وَمَنْ أَضَلُّ مِمَّنْ اِتَّبَعَ هَوَاهُ بِغَيْرِ هُدًى مِنَ اللَّهِ. And whoever is more astray than the person who follows his lusts and his desires, his animal instincts, without any guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمَ الظَّالِمِينَ. Verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't guide such evil-doing people. وَلَقَدْ وَصَّلْنَا لَهُمُ الْقَوْلَ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَذَكَّرُونَ. Actually, we have made our word continuous for them. You know, this wahi has been continuous throughout the human history. From Adam, because it was said to Adam, we have read in Surah Al-Baqarah and Surah Al-Araf also, فَإِمَّا يَاتِيَنَّكُمْ مِنِّي هُدًا فَمَنْ تَبَعَ هُدَايَ فَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. Whenever a guidance would come to you, so whosoever follows the guidance which comes from us, then there will be no fear for them, no grief. But وَالَّذِينَ كَذَّبُوا كَفَرُوا وَكَذَّبُوا بِآيَاتِنَا. Those people who will reject and belie our revelations, أُولَٰئِكَ أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ هُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ. They will be the people of fire and they will stay therein. Now this has been continuous. Allah sent Torah and Zabur and so many other booklets, suhafs, sahife, small books. They have been Suhuf Ibrahim of Musa. Although today we don't know where are Suhuf Ibrahim, which are the Suhuf Ibrahim. But Quran mentions Suhuf Ibrahim of Musa. He was also given some scriptures. Maybe Nuh alayhi salam was also given some scriptures. And there is a new research in India done by a French researcher, scholar. He says, Manu in Bharat is Mahanuh. Nuh, Maha, Mahadev, let's add this word. Mahadev, Mahabharat, the great Bharat. So Maha, the great Nuh, Mahanuh, and his Manu. And Manu Samarthi is the Sharia that was given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to Hazrat Nuh alayhi salatu wa salam. This is a researcher, French, Dubois, and he has worked for 40 long years on the scriptures, Indian scriptures, the religious holy books of the Hindus. So maybe, وَلَقَدْ وَصَّلْنَا لَهُمُ الْقَوْلِ. We have been continuously sending our word for the guidance of the humanity, so that they should be admonished, they should be reminded. الَّذِينَ آتَيْنَاهُمُ الْكِتَابَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِهِ هُمْ بِهِ يُؤْمِنُونَ. As to those whom we gave the book before it, they believe in it. وَإِذَا يُتْلَىٰ عَلَيْهِمْ قَالُوا آمَنَّا بِهِ. And when it is recited unto them, they say, we believe in it. إِنَّهُ الْحَقُّ مِنْ رَبِّنَا. This is the truth from our Lord. إِنَّا كُنَّا مِنْ قَبْلِهِ مُسْلِمِينَ. Actually, we were Muslims even before this. Now this is an incident that took place. You know that some of the Sahaba, they had gone to Abyssinia, taking a refuge over there. It was in the year 5th after the beginning of Wahi. So the people of Abyssinia were introduced to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When the Sahaba went there, they came to know. And Jafar al-Tayyar radiallahu anhu, he recited the ayat of Surah al-Maryam in the court of Magus or Najashi. But after that, a group, a deputation of about 20 Abyssinians came over to Mecca to see what is happening here and who is that person to whom, you know, these revelations have come, and to listen the revelation from Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When they came to Mecca, you know, then these ayat were recited unto them, and they were so much impressed, they wept, and they said, it is all truth. And we were formerly, we believed in it. But these are the things. So this is the incident meant. وَإِذَا يُتْلَىٰ عَلَيْهِمْ قَالُوا آمَنَّا بِهِ. إِنَّهُ الْحَقُّ مِنْ رَبِّنَا. This is the truth from our Lord. إِنَّا كُنَّا مِنْ قَبْلِهِ مُسْلِمِينَ. And we were Muslims. We have surrendered to our Lord even before listening to Quran. Because they were Christians, practicing Christians. So they were, according to the teaching of Hazrat Masih alayhi salatu wasalam, they were Muslims. Ulaika yu'tuna ajrahum marratayn. They are the people who will be given their reward twice. Why? They were already Muslims. They believed in Torah. They believed in Injil. They believed in Moses. They believed in Jesus. Now they have come to believe in Muhammad also, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So actually, they deserve double reward. Those will be given their reward twice over because they endured. مَرَّتَيْنِ بِمَا صَبَرُوا وَيَدْرَعُونَ بِالسَّيِّئَةِ بِالْحَسَنَةِ السَّيِّئَةِ. And they are defending against evil with what is good. وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ. And whatsoever we have given them, they spend for our pleasure. وَإِذَا سَمِعُوا اللَّغْوَ أَعْرَضُوا عَنْهُ. And when they talk, when they listen to the vain talk, the incident took place when they were going back. The news reached Abu Jahl also, that a group of 20 Abyssinians had come to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when they listened to the revelations, according to the claim of Muhammad, that the revelations were from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they were very much impressed. And they said, we believe in them. And now they were going back. So he said, look to these people. They are the most, you know, bewakoof people, you know, foolish people on the surface of the earth. They came, they had a better deen than the deen of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now they came here and now they are going after they have enslaved themselves to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the correct word. When you accept someone as messenger of Allah, you have to obey him. So as if you have now become a slave to him, although we are slaves to Allah, not to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but we follow him. All his commands we have to obey. Atiyu Allah wa atiyu Rasul. You have to obey Allah and you have to obey the messenger also. But when they heard this, that Abu Jahl is saying this type of things, وَإِذَا سَمِعُوا اللَّغْوَ أَعْرَضُوا عَنْهُ. They just turned away from it. وَقَالُوا لَنَا أَعْمَالُنَا وَلَكُمْ أَعْمَالُكُمْ. And they said, for us are our deeds, whatever we do. And for you are your deeds, whatever you do. سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ. Peace be to you. La nabtaghi al-jahileen, we don't want to engage with the ignorant people. Innaka la tahdi man ahbabta walakin Allah yahdi man yasha wa huwa a'lamu bil muhtadin. This is also a very important ayah of the Quran. O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you have not been given the authority to bring to the right path any person whom you like. You cannot bring to the right path any person whom you like. It's the prerogative of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهِ يَعْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ. He brings to the right path whomsoever He wishes. This ayah, you know, is very relevant, especially regarding Abu Talib. Abu Talib was the uncle of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He loved him. He protected him. For 10 long years at Makkah, Abu Talib, he gave him the cover of Banu Hashim because he was the chief of Banu Hashim, the house of Hashim. So they were backing Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, protecting Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Nobody could do anything against Muhammad, against the person of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And it was only after he died that they could take the decision that now we can kill Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now there is no Abu Talib. Abu Talib is gone. But Abu Talib never believed in Muhammad, or at least he never declared his belief in Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So it is given in Sirah that when he was dying at that time also, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to him, "Oh my dear uncle, say this shahada, this testimony, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammad rasulullah, in my ear, so that I can testify on the day of judgment that you had come to believe." But he said, "No, Muhammad, I don't want that the women of Makkah should say that Abu Talib was fearful of death, and at the time of death, he accepted it." So he went from this world in kufr. How much Muhammad must have desired that he should come to believe, we can't imagine. But no, إِنَّكَ لَا تَهْدِي مَنْ أَحْبَبْتَ. You can't guide or bring to the right path anybody whom you like. You might love him your love might be much great. وَلَاكِنْ اللَّهِ عَذِي مَنْ يَشَاءَ He actually gives guidance and brings to the right path whomsoever He wants. وَهُوَ عَلَمُ بِالْمُهْتَدِينَ And He very well knows the people who are ready and who wish to be guided. Unless this wish to be guided is there, this intention to go to the right path is there, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't guide. He guides only who wants to be guided. وَقَالُوا إِنَّ تَبِعِ الْهُدَى مَعَكَ نُتَخَطَّفْ مِنْ أَرْضِنَا Some of the people, they said, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if we follow you, if we follow the guidance that is with you, we shall be snatched away from our land. People will take us away, will kill us. Now the answer from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is, أَوَلَمْ نُمَكِّنْ لَهُمْ حَرَمًا آمِنًا Have we not made this sanctuary, this haram of Makkah, peaceful and secure for them? يُجْبَى إِلَيْهِ سَمَرَاتُ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ Fruits of everything are being drawn to it from every direction. رِزْقًا for a sustenance. بِالَّدُنَّا from our own presence. وَلَكِنَّ أَكْسَرَهُمْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ But most of them don't know the reality. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect you. And even if you are killed, but there was a person, you know, Hazrat Sumayya radiyallahu ta'ala anha, and her husband, Hazrat Yasir radiyallahu anha, they were killed, tortured, and killed by Abu Jahl. So what? They got the shahada. وَلَا تَقُولُوا لِمَنْ يُقْتَلُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ أَمْوَاتٌ وَلَا حِيَاءٌ وَلَكِنْ لَا تَشْعُرُونَ They have attained the real life. So why to fear? You have to obey Allah. You have to follow the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then whatever comes, you have to bear it. وَكَمْ أَهْلَكْنَا مِنْ قَرْيَةٍ بَطِرَتْ مَعِيشَتَهَا And how many townships we destroyed. They were very proud of their way of living. فَتِلْكَ مَسَاكِنُهُمْ لَمْ تُسْكَمْ مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا Now there are those ruins of their cities where they used to live and dwell. But after them, nobody lived in them except for very little time. وَكُنَّا نَحْنُ الْوَارِسِينَ And definitely, we are the inheritors. Everything will remain with us. People will go. One generation goes, the other inherits. The other also goes, the third generation inherits. And then whole humanity will pass away and everything in this world will remain as an inheritance for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا كَانَ رَبُّكَ مُهْلِكَ الْقُرَىٰ And your Lord was not the one who would have destroyed any city حَتَّى يَبْعَثَ فِي أُمِّهَا رَسُولًا But before sending in the central city a messenger. We have read this ayah in Surah Bani Israel also. وَمَا كُنَّا أَتَّى نَبْعَثَ رَسُولًا وَمَا كُنَّا نُعَذِّبُ حَتَّى نَبْعَثَ رَسُولًا So Allah Ta'ala has not been sending that type of chastisement where the whole nation, you know, is exterminated without sending a messenger who warns them, who conveys to them the warnings of Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. And even if after that they stand where they were, they don't accept the call of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then they are exterminated. So, Ummiha, Ummi mother town, in every country, there is the central town. That is why Ummul Qura is the name of Makkah. Makkah was the central town of the whole of the Arabian Peninsula. So, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used to send, not to every city of that area, but the central city, there He sent a messenger. And if the people didn't accept him, then they were chastised. وَمَا أُوتِيتُم مِّن شَيْءٍ فَمَتَاعُ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا Whatsoever is given to you, whatever it is just to fulfill the requirements of this life of this world. وَزِينَتُهَا And in addition, it's also an adornment for you. Good things, good-looking things, good furniture, all these utensils, very fine crockery, this becomes a sort of adornment. وَمَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ خَيْرٌ وَأَبْقَى أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ. But whatever is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is much better, more precious, and it is lasting. It will remain forever. أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ. So don't you have the understanding? أَفَمَنْ وَعَدْنَاهُ وَعَدًا حَسَنًا فَهُوَ لَاقِيهِ. Now, such a person whom we have made, with whom we have made a covenant, and that covenant is a good covenant, and he is going to meet it, is he like the one, كَمَنْ مَتَّعْنَاهُ مَتَعَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا, to whom we have given the material of this worldly life, ثُمَّ هُوَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ مِنَ الْمُحْضَرِينَ, but on the day of resurrection, he will be brought in chains. He will be brought as a culprit, as a guilty person. وَيَوْمَ يُنَادِيهِمْ, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called them, فَيَقُولْ, and he will say, أَيْنَ شُرَكَائِيَ الَّذِينَ كُنْتُمْ تَزْعُمُونَ, where are those whom you thought that they are associated with me, they are partners with me? قَالَ الَّذِينَ حَقَّ عَلَيْهِمُ الْقَوْلُ رَبَّنَا هَا أُولَٰئِ الَّذِينَ أَغْوَيْنَا. Then you know the people, those people on whom the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has proved true, that they are culprits and they are going to be punished in hell. They would say, رَبَّنَا هَا أُولَٰئِ الَّذِينَ أَغْوَيْنَا. These are the people who led us astray. Probably pointing towards their leaders. In every society, as I have been mentioning before, the leaders and مَلَاوُ الْقَوْمِ الَّذِينَ كَذَّبُوا بِآيَاتِنَا, the leaders and chiefs of the nation, they were the opponents of the messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Opponents of Nuh alayhi salam, of Saleh alayhi salam, of Hud alayhi salam, and in the same way, the chiefs of Makkah, different houses of Makkah. The tribe was one, Quraysh, but this tribe was divided into houses. So these are Bani Hashim, they are the progeny of Hashim, they are Banu Umayyah, they are Banu Des, Banu Bakr, and so on and so forth. But you know, all the chiefs, you know, they were opposing Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The common people would say, oh Allah, they deceived us. We wanted to bring, to accept the call of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but they came in the way. رَبَّنَا هَا أُولَٰئِ الَّذِينَ أَغْوَيْنَا أَغْوَيْنَاهُمْ كَمَا غَوَيْنَا. Those people will retort immediately, well, we led you astray because we were astray ourselves. Had we known the truth, we could have led you to the truth. But we were astray. We were lost ourselves. So we took you also to the wrong path. تَبَرَّانَا إِلَيْكَ مَا كُنَّا مَا كَانُوا يَانَا يَعْبُدُونَ. But O Allah, we declare that we are absolutely apart from them. They were not obeying us or following us. Actually, they were themselves had gone astray. وَقِيلَ دُوْ شُرَكَاكُمْ فَدَعُهُمْ. And then it will be said, call those people, call those deities whom you thought they are the partners with Allah. فَدَعُهُمْ, they will call them. فَلَمْ يَسْتَجِيبُوا لَهُمْ. But they will not answer them. وَرَوَوْ الْعَذَابَ, and they will see the chastisement, the punishment, the hell will come in there before them. لَوْ أَنَّهُمْ كَانُوا يَحْتَدُونَ. And then they will think, would that they had been rightly guided. وَيَوْمَ يُنَادِيهِمْ. And then recall the day when he will call them, فَيَقُولُ مَاذَا عَجَبْتُمُ الْمُرْسَلِينَ. What was the answer that you gave to our messengers? We sent you the messengers. The messenger came to you, and they called them, you towards my path, towards me. What was your reply? فَعَمِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمُ الْأَنْبَاءُ. Now everything will be lost to them, and they will become blind for everything. That is, they won't be able to give any reply. يَوْمَئِذٍ فَهُمْ لَا يَتَسَاءَلُونَ. And they will not be able to consult each other also. What answer we can give? We say it in Urdu, city gum ho jayegi. When this will be the question, the city gum ho jayegi, they're lost and they won't be able to give any answer. فَأَمَّا مَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا. So as for those who repented, came to believe, and did good deeds, فَعَسَانْ يَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُفْلِحِينَ. So there is hope that he will become among the prosperous ones, among the successful people. وَرَبُّكَ يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاءُ وَيَخْتَارُ. And your Lord creates whatsoever He wills and chooses. مَا كَانَ لَهُمُ الْخِيَرَةِ They don't have any choice or option. We have been created. I didn't have any option that I should be created or not created. You have been created. Allah never asked you that whether I should create you or not. It's His prerogative. It's His authority. إِنَّ رَبُّكَ يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاءُ وَيَخْتَارُ And your Lord creates whatsoever He wants and He chooses. مَا كَانَ لَهُمُ الْخِيَرَةِ They don't have any option and choice. سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ وَتَعَالَى مَا يُشْرِكُونَ Glorified be Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and exalted be He. Above that they associate with Him. وَرَبُّكَ يَعْلَمُ مَا تُقِنُّ صُدُورُهُمْ وَمَا يُعْلِنُونَ And your Lord knows very well what their chests conceal within them and what they reveal. Allah knows both. وَهُوَ اللَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّهُ And He is Allah, and there is no ilah except Him. لَهُ الْحَمْدُ All praise be to Him. فِي الْأُولَى وَالْآخِرَةِ Both in this world also, and in the Akhirah, in the hereafter also. وَلَهُ الْحُكْمُ And He holds all authority. وَإِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ And towards Him you will be returned. قُلْ أَرَأَيْتُمْ إِنْ جَعَلَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكُمُ اللَّيْلَ سَرْمَدًا إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ Say, have you considered? If Allah had made the night unending over you till the day of resurrection, which God other than Allah shall bring you light? أَرَأَيْتُمْ إِنْ جَعَلَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكُمُ اللَّيْلَ سَرْمَدًا إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ مَنْ إِلَهٌ غَيْرُ اللَّهِ يَأْتِيكُمْ بِضِيَاءٍ أَفَلَا تَسْمَعُونَ Don't you listen? قُلْ أَرَأَيْتُمْ Say to them, have you considered? إِنْ جَعَلَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكُمُ النَّهَارَ سَرْمَدًا إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ Had Allah made the day permanent over you till the day of resurrection, مَنْ إِلَهٌ غَيْرُ اللَّهِ يَأْتِيكُمْ بِلَيْلٍ Who God, which God except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could bring to you the night تَسْكُنُونَ فِيهِ in which you can have a repose? أَفَلَا تُبْصِرُونَ So you don't see? وَمِنْ رَحْمَتِهِ جَعَلَ لَكُمُ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارَ It is out of His mercy that He has made for you night and day. لِتَسْكُنُوا فِيهِ So that you can repose in the night. وَلِتَبْتَغُوا مِنْ فَضْلِهِ And you can get and seek the bounty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during the day. وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ And so that you are thankful to Allah. وَيَوْمَ يُنَادِيهِمْ فَيَقُولُ أَيْنَ شُرَكَائِيَ الَّذِينَ كُنْتُمْ تَزْعُمُونَ Again and again and again this is coming. And the day when He will call them, where are those whom you asserted that they are my associates and my partners and my equals? وَنَزَعْنَا مِنْ كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ شَهِيدًا And we shall draw out from each people a witness and say, فَقُلْنَا هَاتُ بُرْهَانَكُمْ Bring forth your arguments. Your proofs. Hatu burhanakum. Fa'alimu anna al-haqqa lillah. They will come to know that the truth is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whatever He is saying is true. Wa'alla anhum ma kanu yaftaroon. And whatsoever they had been fabricating, well, He is our God and He will intercede on our behalf and such malaika, angels. We worship them also so that they can intercede on our behalf on the Day of Judgment. All these were fabrications. And all these fabrications will be lost to them. They will go away, evaporate. إِنَّ قَارُونَ كَانَ مِنْ قَوْمِ مُوسَى Now there is a story of a person, Qarun. He was an Israeli from the nation of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. But he was a collaborator with Fir'aun. He had much respect in the court of Fir'aun. And I think so, that you know, Fir'aun supported him. Just you know, the Britishers, they used to support and give big contracts to people who were very faithful to them. And the contractors, they then accumulated a lot of wealth. They are the government contractors. They are the suppliers to the government, suppliers to the army. In the same way, this person was that type of a character. And he had a lot of wealth, lot of wealth, lot of wealth. That is why, you know, it is metaphorical, Qarun, Qarun ki daulat, wealth of Qarun, Qarun ka khazana, the treasure of Qarun. That is the story. Inna Qaruna kana min qawmi Musa. Verily, Qarun was also from the people of Moses. Fabagha alayhim. But he stood against them, collaborated with the Fir'aun. وَآتَيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْكُنُوزِ And we had given him the treasures. مَا إِنَّ مَفَاتِحَهُ لَتَنُوءَ بِالْعُصْبَةِ أُولِي قُوَّةٍ Such that the very keys of them would be too heavy even for a group of very sturdy and strong people. So that was the extent of his wealth. The keys of his treasures were so heavy that a number of strong people only could carry them. إِسْقَالَ لَهُ قَوْمُهُ لَا تَفْرَحَ Just recall when his people said to him, Don't be overjoyed, overglad over what Allah has given you. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ الْفَرِحِينَ Allah doesn't like the boasting and overjoyous people. وَابْتَغِ فِيمَا أَتَاكَ اللَّهُ دَارَ الْآخِرَةِ And try to seek the abode of the hereafter. In what Allah has given you, spend your money, your wealth, for some good causes, for the orphans, the widows, the needy, for the propagation of the true da'wah and call to the people, so that you can have the good and virtues of the hereafter by your wealth. وَلَا تَنْسَ نَصِيبَكَ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا And it seems he was miserly also. Don't forget your own share from this world. You should spend your money on yourself also. You should dress yourself properly because you have the wealth. So, وَأَحْسِنْ كَمَا أَحْسَنَ اللَّهُ إِلَيْكَ And you should do good to others as Allah has done good to you. Allah has given you wealth. So now you should do good to the people, the needy, the poor. وَلَا تَبْغِ فَسَادَ فِي الْأَرْضِ And don't create corruption in the land. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ الْمُفْسِدِينَ Verily Allah doesn't like and doesn't love those people who are corruptors and mischief mongers in this land. قَالَ إِنَّمَا أُوتِيتُهُ عَلَىٰ عِلْمٍ عِنْدِي He said, Verily all this wealth has been given to me on the basis of or due to the knowledge that I have. Allah has not given it to me. I have earned it out of my own skills, my intelligence, my knowledge. I could be an expert in such things. That is why I got this wealth. And you are saying that it is given to me by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No. I have earned it through my own knowledge and skill. قَالَ إِنَّمَا أُوتِيتُهُ عَلَىٰ عِلْمٍ عِنْدِي أَوَلَمْ يَعْلَمْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ أَهْلَكَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ مِنَ الْقُرُونَ Didn't he know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had destroyed before him also many a generation مَنْ هُوَ أَشَدُّ مِنْهُ قُوَّةً وَأَكْسَرَ جَمْعًا Who were more powerful than him and more wealthy than him. لَا يُسْأَلُ عَنْ ذُنُوبِهِمُ الْمُجْرِمُونَ And you know those guilty people shall not be questioned about their sins. They will be straight off thrown into the hell. فَخَرَجَ عَلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ فِي زِينَتِهِ Now one day he came out to show off his wealth to his people. In his pomp and show, فَخَرَجَ عَلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ فِي زِينَتِهِ قَالَ الَّذِينَ يُرِيدُونَ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا Now when people saw his pomp and show, his glittering dresses, his servants, you know, walking and marching beside him, in front of him, behind him, all these things. So those people who want only this worldly life, قَالَ الَّذِينَ يُرِيدُونَ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا يَا لَيْتَ لَنَا مِثْلَ مَا أُوتِيَ قَارُونَ Would that we had also been given the same as has been given to Qarun. إِنَّهُ لَذُو حَظٍ عَظِيمٍ Surely he is a man of mighty good fortune. How fortunate he is. How blessed he is. How much Allah has given him. Would that Allah should have given us also. وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُ الْعِلْمِ Said those people who had been given the knowledge. سَوَابُ اللَّهِ خَيْرُ لِمَنْ آمَنَ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا The reward of Allah is much better than this worldly wealth. For those who come to believe and do good deeds, وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا وَلَا يُلَقَّاهَا إِلَّا الصَّابِرُونَ But this position cannot be attained except by those who are persevering. فَخَسَفْنَا بِهِ وَبِدَارِهِ الْأَرْضِ. So we made the earth to swallow him and his dwelling. His soul, his palace, all his wealth, all his family, he himself, they were swallowed by the earth. The earth broke and everything went in. فَخَسَفْنَا بِهِ وَبِدَارِهِ الْأَرْضِ فَمَا كَانَ لَهُ مِنْ فِيَةٍ يَنْصُرُونَهُ. At that time, he didn't have any armies who could have saved him, who could have helped him. مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ Besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَمَا كَانَ مِنَ الْمُنْتَصِرِينَ. And also, it was not possible for him to avenge himself. وَأَصْبَى الَّذِينَ تَمَنَّوا مَكَانَهُ بِالْأَمْسِ. Now those people who, on the previous day, were wishing to be like him, that would be that Allah had given also us all this treasure and all this wealth in this world. Now they became, فَأَصْبَحَ الَّذِينَ تَمَنَّوا مَكَانَهُ بِالْأَمْسِ يَقُولُونَ. Now they started saying, وَيْكَانَ اللَّهَ يَفْسُطُ الرِّزْقَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ وَيَقْدِرُ. It's for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He outspreads the sustenance of this world for whomsoever he likes. And he restricts them for whomsoever he likes. وَيْكَانَهُ لَوْ لَا أَنْمَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَيْنَا لَخَسَفَ بِنَا. Had Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not done good to us and be gracious to us, he would have made us also be swallowed by the earth. وَيْكَانَهُ لَا يُفْلِحُ الْكَافِرُونَ. Ah, the disbelievers do not prosper. Now the final section of the surah, the conclusion of all these discussions. تِلْكَ الدَّارُ الْآخِرَةُ نَجْعَلُهَا لِلَّذِينَ لَا يُرِيدُونَ عُلُوًا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا فَسَادًا. This is the life, this is the house of the hereafter, Darul Akhirah. And we have assigned it, and we shall keep it reserved for those who desire not exaltation in this world, nor corruption. They don't want, aspire to go high, and to hold authority, and to have more wealth, and more pomp and show. No. تِلْكَ الدَّارُ الْآخِرَةُ نَجْعَلُهَا لِلَّذِينَ لَا يُرِيدُونَ عُلُوًا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا فَسَادًا. This house of the hereafter, we have kept reserved for those who are not very ambitious for this world. If you are ambitious for this world, you will get something. You might have a bigger mansion, a bigger villa, a bigger house. You might have a longer car, you know, a bigger television, all these things you can have. But, you know, but in the Akhira, you don't have anything then. تِلْكَ الدَّارُ الْآخِرَةُ نَجْعَلُهَا لِلَّذِينَ لَا يُرِيدُونَ عُلُوًّا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا فَسَادًا وَالْعَاقِبَةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. And the happy end is only for those who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah include us all in them. مَنْ جَعَى بِالْحَسَنَةِ فَلَهُ خَيْرٌ مِّنْهَا. Whosoever will come there with something which is good, good deeds, for him will be much better than that. Allah will reward him much better than he had brought as good deeds. وَمَنْ جَعَى بِالْسَيِّئَةِ. But whoever will come there with bad deeds, فَلَا يُجْزَى الَّذِينَ عَمِلُوا السَّيِّئَاتِ إِلَّا مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. But those who are doing evil, they will not be recompensed or rewarded, but exactly equal to what they had done. When rewarding good, Allah will give more. But when rewarding the bad, he will give only that much punishment which you have earned. إِنَّ الَّذِي فَرَضَ عَلَيْكَ الْقُرْآنَ لَرَادُّكَ إِلَىٰ مَعَادٍ. Verily, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he who has ordained upon you this Qur'an. فَرَضَ عَلَيْكَ الْقُرْآنَ. فَرَضَ, ordained upon you. What does it mean? He has ordained upon you to convey this Qur'an to your nation, to convey this Qur'an to the humanity at large through your ummah. This is the duty of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. إِنَّ الَّذِي فَرَضَ عَلَيْكَ الْقُرْآنَ. Whosoever has put this burden on your shoulders, this responsibility of conveying the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to humanity, لَرَادُّكَ إِلَىٰ مَعَاد. He will definitely take you back to the best end. Now what does it mean? The best returning, the best place of returning. There are different views of the exegesis of the Mufassirin regarding this. Number one is that you will return to Makkah after Hijrah. There is an incident they narrate that when Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was going towards Medina, while he was immigrating, he has chosen a route which was not mostly used because he feared that he will be followed. So, but then at a certain point, this was the highway going, and because he had chosen another route, at certain point this new route that he adopted went and struck and ran into that route, the normal highway. Now here when he was standing, if he turns to the right, it is to Medina. If he turns to the left, it is to Makkah. So at that juncture, the Prophet stood for some time, and he was grieved that he is not going towards Makkah, he is going away from Makkah. So at that time this ayah was revealed, that we shall take you back to Makkah, don't grieve. A time will come, and it was only after 8 years that he came back to Makkah victorious. He conquered Makkah with 10,000 of his companions accompanying him. So one meaning is this, that some exegetes, you know, have taken. But the others say no. It is for Akhirah. Ma'ad actually is mostly used in Quran for the hereafter. So in the hereafter, best places are reserved for you. Maqam of Mahmood, Maqam of intercession, the station of intercession you will have. And you will be given the Maqam of Mahmood, as we have read in Surah Bani. Asa'in yab'asaka rabbuka Maqam of Mahmooda. So that is the, but the assurance to Muhammad is, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that he will not fail, you will be triumphant, you will be successful, you will successfully finish your mission that has been given to you, and then you will return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in absolute peace and contentment. For Rabbi Alamu Manja bil Huda, say, my Lord very well knows who comes with guidance, who has brought guidance, Waman huwa fi dhalali mubeen, and the one who is in the manifest error, on the wrong path, apparently on the wrong path. وَمَا كُنْتَ تَرْجُوَ يُلْقَى إِلَيْكَ الْكِتَابِ. And O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you were not expecting and hoping that this book will be sent to you. He was not that type of person. He was a trader, a normal human being. He was never, you know, after the kahins, or after the rabbis, and after these people, to learn some spirituality, nothing of this sort. He was a gentleman, having good moral character, lovable behavior, and a successful trader. He never expected, he never thought, that this book of Allah will be revealed to him. وَمَا كُنْتَ تَرْجُوَ يُلْقَى إِلَيْكَ الْكِتَابِ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً مِّن رَبِّكَ. Accept this, that it has been a mercy of your Lord to you. Allah has chosen you. You were not expecting it. That is why when the first wahi came to him, he was astonished. He was perspiring. He was trembling. When he came back from this Mount of Nur, from the cave of Hira, after the first revelation, he was perspiring, I can think, trembling. And he said to his wife, Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha, Zammeluni, Zammeluni, cover me up, cover me up. Inni khashitu ala nafsi, I fear for my life. What is going to happen to me? What is this new thing that has come to me? What is this responsibility that has been put on my shoulder? So it was nothing that you aspired. It was actually Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala assigned you with this task. مَا كُنْتَ تَرْجُوَ يُلْقَى إِلَيْكَ الْكِتَابُ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً مِّن رَبِّكَ فَلَا تَكُونَنَّ زَهِيرًا لِلْكَافِرِينَ. So you should not be a supporter of the disbelievers. What does it mean? The disbeliever might be very much dear to you. Abu Talib might be very much dear to you. But you can't ask my forgiveness for him. Any other disbeliever, maybe he is very dear to you. But if he disbelieves, he is not accepting your call, then don't ask me for any forgiveness. فَلَا تَكُونَنَّ زَهِيرًا لِلْكَافِرِينَ. وَلَا يَسُدَّنَّكَ عَنْ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ بَعْدَ إِذْ أُنْزِلَتْ إِلَيْكَ. And let not these disbelievers divert you from the revelations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when they have been sent to you. وَدُعُ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ. And keep on calling people towards your Lord. Keep on calling. In the former surah we had, وَأَنْ أَتْلُوَ الْقُرْآنَ. I have been commanded that I should continue reciting Qur'an unto you. فَمَنِ اِهْتَدَىٰ فَإِنَّمَا يَهْتَدِي لِنَفْسِهِ. Whosoever gets the guidance, well, he gets the guidance for himself. His own benefit. وَلَا يَسُدَّنَّكَ عَنْ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ بَعْدَ إِذْ أُنْزِلَتْ إِلَيْكَ. وَدُعُ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ. وَلَا تَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. And don't be in any way from among the associators. وَلَا تَدْعُ مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَٰهًا آخَرَ. Don't call with Allah any other God. لَا إِلَٰهَ إِلَّا هُ. There's no God except He. كُلُّ شَيْءٍ هَالِكٌ إِلَّا وَجْهَهُ. Everything will vanish. Everything is fani. Everything is temporary. Everything is halik. It will disappear and vanish from existence. إِلَّا وَجْهَهُ. Except His face. Accept His countenance. Now this ayah is very profound. You know, there is a concept that when the doomsday is coming, a part of the universe will be destroyed, not the whole of the universe. يَوْمَ تُبَدَّلُ الْأَرْضُ غَيْرُ الْأَرْضِ وَالسَّمَاوَاتُ. The shape of this world will be changed. The shape of this earth will be changed. The shape of the heavens will change. But it is not that every existence will cease, no. But in the long run, a time will come when everything will cease to exist except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. كُلُّ مَنْ عَلَيْهَا فَانْ وَيَبْقَى وَجْهُ رَبِّكَ ذُو الْجَلَالِ وَالْإِكْرَامِ. A time will come. كُلُّ شَيْءٍ هَالِكٌ إِلَّا وَجْهَهُ لَهُ الْحُكْمُ. For Him is the authority. وَإِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ. And to Him will you be returned.